Good morning. It is quiet. It is clear. Nice to say that we don't have any snow happening right now. The problem is that threat for that type of winter weather has been replaced by the intense cold that we're dealing with this morning. We have some trouble with wind chills and air temperatures here as you get ready to head out the door. You're definitely going to want to make sure that you are completely layered up. And you'll probably want to get that car started early to warm it up for you here too. Let's take a look at the advisories that we have in place here. We've got a wind chill warning first off in the Northern Valley, includes Grand Forks over to Devil's Lake, anywhere in purple here. That's for wind chills down to 50 below. And this is through 7 a.m. because that's when we're seeing some of our worst wind chills. Once that expires, it will be replaced by what the rest of us are dealing with, a wind chill advisory with wind chills down to 40 below for the morning hours and even into the afternoon for some places. So here's a look at those numbers right now. It's 47 below your wind chill in Grand Forks, a wind chill of 45 below in Langdon. Your exposed skin at those wind chills can freeze in a matter of 10 minutes or less in some of these instances. So this is something you want to take seriously. I know we are proud of being North Dakotans and being able to handle the cold weather, but it still has those kind of impacts on your body. So please take care of yourself here and make sure you've got that winter survival kit with you in your car in case you run into car trouble. Temperatures right now into the teens and 20s below zero. One spot, Fossum, was down to 31 below. We've seen a slight improvement there at 27 below. Probably doesn't feel any different. 21 below in Fargo and 26 below in Grand Forks. The wind isn't that strong. It's pretty light. We do have a couple of places seeing some winds out of the west or northwest into the low teens. Nothing to show you on our satellite map. It's quiet. It's clear. So let's talk about this cold weather. It's going to be with us all day. With temperatures this low, it's just going to be a struggle to warm up today. We'll have some sunshine. That'll be nice. But it's January sunshine, just not strong enough to really warm us much. But we do see those temperatures rise into the single digits below zero for a good portion of the valley. Some of us might not get there. You see Grand Forks and Devil's Lake there, but we are going to see those temperatures climb. The wind does switch to a southerly direction through the day today, and it starts to increase as we head into tonight. And this is in advance of that next system that we're keeping an eye out for. So by 7 o'clock this evening, temperatures start to dip, but the wind starts to pick up too. And that will actually prevent our temperatures from dropping anymore, or actually we might see some of those numbers go up as these winds continue to increase. Here's the problem with that. As we head into tomorrow morning, we're not seeing any snow yet, but we've got some wind gusts into the 30s and 40s happening Friday morning. And we just got that fresh snow from this last system. That's going to get picked up and blown around. So we're going to be dealing with blowing snow, whiteout conditions, especially in open country, even before the snow starts up on Friday, as long as we see those intense winds. Heading into the later morning and into the afternoon, you see those clouds start to build in more and more, and our chances for snow will increase Friday afternoon into the evening and eventually into the overnight hours, with those winds remaining strong as well. So once the snow starts up, you can see it starting to build into the Southern Valley, especially around 3 o'clock. We'll see even worsening conditions with the falling snow getting blown around. Your temperatures much warmer than today. We're going to be in the teens to some 20s. It's just not going to feel that great with the wind blowing that and bringing down our wind chills. Heading into Friday night, that snow continues to build into Lakes Country and spreads even more as the system develops and gets closer to us. You can see eastern viewing area going to be more of the focus, lesser chances for snow out to the west, though we do have that potential heading through Friday and into Saturday. So here's a look at one of our model scenarios of what we may expect to see. These deeper blues, that's 6 to 12 inches of snow potential. You can see it's more likely for the farther south and closer to Minneapolis you get, but some of our viewers may end up in that range. And regardless of whether we see a lot of snow or not, and we all have a chance for some snow, lesser amounts to the west again, regardless of that chance, that wind is going to be a problem no matter what Friday and heading into Saturday. We do have a winter storm watch. It covers the entire Red River Valley. And again, that's for tomorrow afternoon and into Saturday for us. So here's your 7-day planner. Expect temperatures to be milder for your Friday. Saturday, of course, going to be colder once that system moves on. And then we stay cold heading into the holiday on Monday, start to see some hints at warming on Wednesday.
At least you said it earlier. I can see the light at the end of the tunnel. Yes. This is a long stretch.
It is. And we had a nice start to January, so this is kind of a rude awakening for us, too.
Thank you, Lisa.
As we've been talking about, our weather today is just downright miserable. And coming up, Abby Furchner explains how quickly frostbite can set in and what you should do to protect yourself.